11th of the Mass intention is for the peoples of the soul of Tamara, that's it, requested by her mother, Mrs. A. Washington, and her sister, Mrs. G. Tillman. Do not abandon me, Lord, my God. Do not go away with me.
Hurry up to help,
Lord, my Savior. Please stand now. Welcome, Father John Breslin, chaplain of Cook County. Our gathering song is, how great they are, how great thou art. Number 181 in the leading light.
We call upon that triune God in the name of the Father and the Son. Spirit.
Amen.
May the merciful, may the healing, and may the redeeming love of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. We know that there are many times in our lives that we're proud of ourselves. There are many times in our lives that we even want to hide from God. Before we approach His throne of grace this morning, we just bow our head in humble submission to God as we ask for forgiveness of our sins.
Lord,
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, by whose gift your faithful offer you right and praiseworthy service, grant we humbly pray that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the things you have promised. For our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, ever and ever. Amen.
Therefore, you rebuke offenders.
Cherokee license plate X172194. You're blocking someone in.
Our second reading today is from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. My brothers and sisters, we pray always for you, that our God may make you worthy of his calling and powerfully bring to fulfillment every good purpose and every effort of faith, that the name of our Lord Jesus may be glorified and you in him, in accord with the grace of our God and Lord Jesus Christ. We ask you, brothers and sisters, with regard to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our assembling with him, not to be shaken out of your minds suddenly, or to be alarmed either by a spirit or an oral statement, or by a letter, allegedly from us, to the effect that the day of the Lord is at hand. Yes. This, my brothers and sisters, is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. sisters, my brothers, may the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. At that time, Jesus came to Jericho and intended to pass through the town. Now a man there named Zacchaeus, who was a chief tax collector and also a wealthy man, was seeking to see who Jesus was. But he could not see him because of the crowd, for he was short in stature. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore tree in order to see Jesus, who was about to pass that way. When he reached a place, Jesus looked up and said, "Zacchaeus, come down quickly, for today I must stay at your house." And he came down quickly and received him with joy. When they all saw this, they began to grumble, saying, "He has gone to stay at the house of a sinner." But Zacchaeus stood there and said to the Lord, "Behold, half of my possessions, Lord, I shall give to the poor. And if I have extorted anything from anyone, I shall repay it four times over." And Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because this man too is a descendant of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save what was lost." And my sisters and brothers, this is indeed the good news of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Africa. I'm talking about 71st and prayer. beautiful bungalow. Every week, 800 people are lined up. And out of 800 people, what struck me, what I saw that I'll never forget. Out of 800 people that line up every Wednesday, winter, spring, summer, or fall, out of 800 people, 80 to 85%, I've been told, are over 70 years of age. You hear me? 80 to 85% of the 800 people are over 75, 80 years old, man. Shame on us. Shame on us. When I look out there, what I saw was people who paved the way. What I saw out there was men and women who worked a lot of years at the old way. Working at places so that the children would rise. And mother and father were working their fingers to the bone. Now I'm standing in the line for a loaf of bread and a head of cabbage. Shame on us. Something that you see, you'll never forget. As a vision, I serve as chaplain now at a place called Strobinger Hospital. And I see things, and I've been around, but I see things I never thought of. Some time ago, I was called to a unit in the hospital. I know people here are physicians and nurses, they've been around and seen a whole lot. But I saw something. There was a 16-month-old baby just got out of surgery, 8.5 hours of surgery. 16-month-old baby boy. Beautiful baby. 8.5 hours surgery to reconstruct his skull. Because somebody, whether it was a mama, whether it was a daddy, the boyfriend, or the girlfriend, somebody, according to the police and the physicians, because what they see, they can identify. They saw that the child was grabbed by the ankles and spun around the room. Repeatedly hit a wall. Some things you'll see can change you forever. And I would go and I'd pray for the little baby boy. You see, what happened is the police and the people of county, they got serious about it. Nobody could see that child. Because everybody was protecting everybody. I don't know who did it. You have a 16-month-old baby, you don't need a baby there to help by itself. Somebody had to see something. If that was my mama, she would find out who would do it. If that was my daddy, I hate to say it, but there would have been some street justice. But the police met with their mother, met with their father, met with the boyfriend, met with the girlfriend, met with them all. And nobody saw anything. Code of silence. And thank God for the Chicago police and the people at Trojan. Because they put a lock on anybody seeing that child. Except for yours truly. And every half hour, between 12:30 and 1, the parent could be there with two police that were ready. Some things you'll see, you'll never forget. And after about the 12th or 13th week, it was a blessing. Because those nurses and people that were treated the child like they were home. And one day I was there, something you'll see, you'll never forget. That nurse helped that child. There's all sorts of tubes and other things developing from the child. The nurse held the first time the baby was going to eat solid food. And she took some applesauce. You know, applesauce is the most sweet and sour. And that child. reality for the first time in many weeks, tasted something. And the lesson was, we almost did a holy dance right in the road because the child squished up his nose and his eyes and his face because of the applesauce. But we were so excited because his senses, being able to taste, began to resurface. Something that you see, you'll never forget. Scripture. Zacchaeus, one of my favorite biblical people. Now, Zacchaeus is different. I don't need to insult everybody, but some. Well, Zacchaeus, Scripture, this is from the Word. This isn't from Father John. This is from the Word. Zacchaeus was short. He was a short man. Now, you ever want to insult a man, call him short. Zacchaeus, you know what I'm saying. We just don't say it. You want to insult somebody, the other man, tell you he's a short man. But you see what happened? Zacchaeus was a short man. But Zacchaeus, he was a tax collector. Now, we know from our study of Scripture and history about tax collectors. They were considered less than two-legged dogs. Because tax collectors, because they were so despised by everybody, they were despised even by the people that would go to the temple on Sabbath. They were so despised because the tax collector was a thief, a cheat, somebody that would rob other people so that their own pockets would be filled. And Zacchaeus knew all that. Zacchaeus knew, you see, when heaven tax collectors even handled the money from Gentiles, and that made them impure. And so nobody wanted, they were worse than Samaritans. They didn't wear a bell around their neck and say, I'm on my way, but everybody knew who they were. And Zacchaeus, in a short man, was even worse. Tax collector and a short man. But Zacchaeus wanted to see. He wanted to see something. You see, once you see something, something will change you. And Zacchaeus, because he was a short man and he was despised, nobody wanted to be around him. Zacchaeus ran to heaven and had a whole crowd because everybody kept talking about this man by the name of Jesus. He said, I want to see for myself. So Zacchaeus is a grown man. What did he do? He climbed up a tree. Crazy. Grown man climbed up a tree because he wanted to see. Some things you want to see, and it will change you. And Zacchaeus, the tax collector, despised him, and the short man looked down from the tree, and he saw the man by the name of Jesus. And Jesus was in Jericho, just passing through, and he began to teach and preach. And all of a sudden, Jesus looked up and said, Zacchaeus, I want to stay at your house. I bid you come down. And now, church folk will be for ourselves. Some things that we see will change us forever. Jesus. How do we see him? Do we see him as the Jesus we were taught about as children? Do we see him as the Jesus who our grandmother talked to him about, our father talked about? Or do we see Jesus for who we know that he is? Do we see Jesus the one that can touch, the one that can heal, the one that can deliver, the one that can sustain, the one that can live, the one that can do everything but faith? You see, one something to see a change of heaven. Whether it's a lady raised in age with silver hair, waiting for a head of cabbage in a bag of potato chips and a loaf of bread. Something that you see changes forever. As a little boy that nobody dare admit that they did something wrong to, is it Zacchaeus who saw Jesus as he had a little down and he cried? How do we see Jesus? Now, I'm not talking about the intellectual understanding of who Jesus is. Some people have that, and they have that in a brilliant capacity. But I don't talk about the intellectual Jesus that sometimes they give you the scripture, quote a chapter and a verse, and what book it comes from, and how it was written. But I'm talking about once you see Jesus, you'll never be the same type of Jesus when you realize that he's here. You see, sometimes, I don't know about you, but sometimes there are some Christian Catholics who I know who don't realize that every time they gather around the altar, when the words are prayed, the action is lived out, and the faith is manifested. When the word is prayed over the simple gift of the bread and the wine, the simple gift of the bread and the wine no longer is the bread and the wine, but truly becomes that body and that blood of Jesus Christ. Because we realize that Jesus that lives within us allows us to claim and to cry out, I can do all things.
Thank you.
We only allow him to order our steps. Some things that we see can change us forever.
Yes.
Some things that we see can change us forever.
Yes. Yes.
It is the God of mysterious ways who brings us together. No one is here on the stage with you. Each and every one of us is brought here for a reason. To stand in the ground with holy and consecrated. This is not the Zanzibar, this is not the David Gagel. This is the ground. And that's why I dare the devil to step up from here. I don't know about your scripture, my scripture says you can have power and get behind it. Something that we see can change us forever. We're about to see something that is altered. Our common prayer is going to transform these gifts. And something powerful is going to happen. It ain't a magic show. It's the word of God come alive, manifested in this heart. As he brought us together, I invite you now to join with me. As different as we are, we stand together, and we pray together in prayer that unites us in our journey of faith. Unites us in the steps that we have to take. And we turn to page 69 of the book of Mr. Lefkowitz. And we proclaim with faith that unites us. For I believe in one God, the Father of all men, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God,
God may heal the sick, comfort the dying,
and bring the departed to the joy of his presence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the poor, the lonely, the hungry, the homeless, those unemployed, those suffering from addiction, and those who have no one to pray for them, that God, in his mercy, will draw close to them and rescue them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Pray for our faithful body members. Angela Bowen Barr, Patricia Dancy, Thomas Fisher, Patty Gray, Lewis Gray, Gerald James III, Julia Jones, Ruth Jones Mills, Annette O'Neill, Dorothy Forche, Ramona Sears, Johnny Simmons, Carolyn Smith, Shannon Thomas and George Fletcher, William Tuggee, Maddie Walker, Juanita Whiteside, Elsie Williams, John and Willie Woods. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Please now add your own intentions aloud in silence.
Pray for children that always be held as sacred gifts from God, never to be used or abused. We pray for parents who struggle with the gift of parenthood. We pray that they'll be led and guided by the Spirit. For this prayer, Lord.
Lord,
hear our
prayers.
Guide our form of love for us is without limit. May the tithe to the altar we bring to the altar be an outpouring of our joy and thanksgiving for what God freely gives. Our preparation song is I Surrender All, hymn 235, and lead me guide.
Thank you.
Mr. Bittner, in those days, way back in the day, the woman I knew, my name was Ada, she would sing that song, the tower was right here. She would sit in front of me in the car. Yeah. And then when I was too young, good looking, but now I'm good. Now I'm good looking. The tower was in that. I was proud to say that that song lifted me and sustained me and stuff that made me proud.
You are indeed holy, O Lord. You are the Father of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts of prayer, that send down your spirit of humble and like the they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his own passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, eat. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, he was suffering with him. He took the chalice. Once more, he gave thanks. Gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from me. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me."
Praise you through your Son,
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Yeah.
one of the traditions in Holy Ages. Each church is a little different than I know it.
Thank you.
wanted an additional custom ritual within our church. As we remember and as we pray for, we say a simple prayer when we gather with the deceased. Eternal light shine, may the perpetual light shine upon the eternal rest crown of the Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May this soul and all souls of faith and pardon, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Second collection for the
parish registration forms is the only card we use.
The HIV-AIDS citizen is the son of long-sleeve red t-shirt, Angel's Babies. We will take orders starting on Sunday, October 27th through November 24th. We ask the parents, parishioners who purchase the shirts to wear them on World AIDS Day, and for any of our ministry events throughout the year, please see any ministry members for details. Please let Rosemary Sykes at 708-275-5930. If you have any questions. Next Sunday, there will be a second collection for the Archdiocese for the Military Church. Please read the bulletin and insert for more detailed information. Those are announcements.
I thank Father Smith for inviting me. Father Smith and I go back a little way, and he extended an invitation to come and pray with you today. So I thank you so much for allowing me. Power's hand, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.